Hello viewers, I'm Frank from the TechyV.com, your solution provider. I'm introducing you Jitbit Macro Recorder, a keystroke and mouse click recording software exclusive for Windows operating systems. It's an efficient tool for recording macros with advanced editing interface and then playing them in its own player or save it to a self-executable file for standalone automation. As an alternative to recording, you can assign your macros to hotkeys and run them for application. It detects images as screen icons whenever window position changes, and it integrates with Windows Shell and supports scheduling as well. It's very tiny, about 1.5 megawatts, and consumes very low system memory for smooth performance. To get it, go to Jitbit's website and you'll see a free trial download link on the top. Click on it, a downloader will launch immediately. Save it. Then run it and extraction and verification will start. Now click install and it will download and install the rest. It will run automatically after download completes. Since it's a trial use, so I'm clicking evaluate. Now this is Jitbit's interface. To record any activities, click on the record button and it will hide in background. Now whatever you do, your mouse movements and click and keystrokes will be recorded. To pause it, click pause recording and click stop recording to stop. Jitbit's window will reappear again. See, your total activities has been recorded. Now it shows icon based list of it, the mouse movements in these points and the keys I pressed. Now to play it and give it a try, click the play button. Look, I'm not doing anything now. This software is just playing my activities which I've just recorded. To save this project, launch the file menu, then click save or press Ctrl and S key together. This will save it as a .mcr macro file, which you can play later by opening this file again and click the play button, or you can save it as a .exe so that it can be launched without Jitbit's player. Just run this file to launch this macro. Instead of recording a macro, you can manually create one. For an example, it will open Mozilla Firefox and then search in Google something. To do this, drag your mouse on these icons and an info will be displayed about the type of commands can be placed. To launch a file or program, click File Commands and then select Open File or Program command. Now I can browse my file and locate it here. And since Mozilla is a program, I can simply put it as firefox.exe. You can test this launch and click OK. It can take some time to load Firefox completely, so I'm putting an approximate delay command. My Firefox homepage is set to Google search, so I'll just insert a type command in it. Then it will press the enter key on keyboard. Then another delay command to show up the search result. Then click the first search. But before that, I will check my cursor point position. Click on insert a mouse command and it will show you position. Alright, this is my position and I will remember it and put it exactly on the X and Y coordinate fields. Now I can play and check this macro. To check keyboard shortcuts, click the tools menu and click settings. Select the tab keyboard shortcuts hotkeys and you will see a list of hotkeys. You can control playback speed on the playback settings tab. You can also merge saved macro commands from your previous saved ones. Alright, that's it. Thanks for watching and don't forget to check out the TechyV.com.